The best drawing tablets for 2021. Top 5 review. Whether you're a beginner or a seasoned pro, a drawing tablet can be an invaluable tool in your digital art toolkit. Drawing tablets offer the ability to turn your laptop or computer into a digital drawing surface. With a drawing tablet, you can capture ideas and build detailed images digitally. However, not all drawing tablets are created equal. Some allow you to draw with a stylus, and some have drawing surfaces that are specifically designed for specific tasks. Drawing tablets have been around for a long time, and they keep getting better and better every year. We've selected the best drawing tablets on the market based on our expertise in the field. If you're looking for the best drawing tablets of 2021, then this list is for you. We have analyzed 2,856 customer reviews and looked at 75 products to give you this top 5 video review. If you are interested in any of the drawing tablets in this list, we have included the links in the description box below. Keep watching to find the perfect one. At number 5 is the XP Pen Deco Mini 7 Wireless Drawing Tablet. If you like to draw or do digital art, you should consider getting the XP Pen Deco Mini 7. It's a 7x4.37-inch tablet with a very nice rounded and curved design. The pen has 8 pressure levels and works with Windows and Mac computers. It has a USB-C port for easy connectivity to mobile devices and also has a wireless connection option to your laptop. When used with a laptop, the tablet has a full-size 10.6 active drawing area. It has a nice rounded design and has a lot of features. You can get the wireless version for less than $50, making it one of the cheapest models on this list. Also, this model comes with a battery-free, P05D stylus. While it is very convenient, you have to pay extra for the wireless version. Since this is a smaller tablet, it might not work as well with larger displays as larger ones. However, if you're working on a smaller computer, this one could be a good choice. Customers who like these write in their review:
easy to set up and use, even with my Android. It's definitely great for beginners. I have to say that the XP Pen tablet is worth the money. It is easy to use and it also allows you to work on Photoshop and similar programs.
And what a few of them don't like.
There is a learning curve to it and you're not likely to want to fully resolve your mouse with it, although technically you probably could.
At number 4 we have the Wacom, Wacom 1. While Wacom Cintiq may be the industry standard, the Wacom 1 offers a more approachable price point for a beginning and intermediate artists. It features a 13.3-inch, 1080p display, and comes with a pressure-sensitive pen. You can use the included stylus or your own, and there are numerous drawing and painting apps for Windows, macOS, and Android devices. A Wacom pen has pressure sensitivity, which helps with accurate painting on the go. It has a reliable pen plus Android compatibility, making it easier than ever to get started with digital art. While it may not have the same features as its more expensive cousin, the Wacom Cintiq, it does include a number of useful features. For instance, you can draw directly on the display using the included pen. When you draw with the pen, you can magnify or reduce the image to help with perspective. It has 8 pressure sensitivity levels, which can help with muscle memory. Another plus is that the Wacom One has a built-in stand that provides several angles for drawing. It isn't as sleek as some of the others' models, but at this price, it's still a quality drawing tool. If you are looking for a tablet that can meet the needs of beginners or even hobbyists, we recommend starting with this model. It has everything you need for a beginning drawing tablet. This is the top things customers are saying about the Wacom One.
The tablet is really easy to use and to set up overall with the addition of very little hardware smoothing, with the use of the Open Tablet Driver or the Haka Driver. This makes the editing process so much quicker and less painful on the wrist.
Few customers who bought this thought that.
The pen nibs definitely wear down fast, though.
Moving on to the next drawing tablet on our list, the Intuos CTL4100 from Wacom. Wacom is known as one of the leading manufacturers of graphics tablets and has been around for quite some time. And the Intuos CTL4100 is still one of the best values on the market and is a great starting point for anyone who wants to get into graphics tablet work. It doesn't have a fancy feature set, but it works really well and has a solid build quality. Its size isn't the biggest advantage of the Intuos, but it does have a decent number of intuitive and programmable functions. Wacom has recently updated their firmware, and there are some nice improvements to the tablet as well as some newer additions like the Wacom Pen 5K, which is now part of the Intuos. The pen has a 4K resolution and offers 4096 pressure levels. You can use it with Windows or Mac devices with Windows 10 or macOS X 10.11. It's also available in different colors. If the Intuos isn't for you, then there is also a Bluetooth version of this tablet available for a little extra money. Customers who bought these like that.
A highly recommended tool for digital image work. It's also great for a beginner. The setup process is simple. Great starting tablet for beginner digital artists or graphic designers. I use it for traveling since it's small and it fits well inside my laptop bag.
And what a few of them don't like?
I can say there definitely is a learning curve to using graphics tablets to draw, and I'm still a bit clumsier with it than I am with real pencil and paper.
At number 2 we have the Gaomon PD1161 11.6 inches drawing tablet. Wacom has faced increasing competition in the tablet market in recent years, with the likes of the Gaomon PD1560, Intuos Pro 11, and the Lenovo Yoga 710 Pro vying for the same space. However, Wacom's premium products can often be found for significantly less money. And the Gaomon PD1560 is one of the newest competitors to appear on the scene. It has 8,192 levels of pressure sensitivity, the same sizable display, and the same number of express keys, but it comes with a number of additional accessories including a stylus holder, screen protector, and a bag to transport it in. The PD1161 has an 11.6 inch display and comes with a stylus with 8 different tips, plus a ballpoint pen with an included rubber tip. It's a great tablet for anyone who wants to draw or design, but can't justify the price of the bigger models. It also has a decent number of extra features, including a USB-C cable, charger, and stand, all in one box. Gaomon's tablet isn't quite up to the standard Wacom level, though you will probably get more value for your money if you aren't doing a lot of heavy-duty digitizing. It's also available with a wide range of display options, from widescreen to 4K resolution. Customers loves the PD1161, 11.6 inches drawing tablet because
this tablet was a pure joy to work with. I love the fact that it has a screen that reflects what is shown on the computer. Just a handy tablet that's a very portable and convenient size, but still works very efficiently.
Some customers did not like the following.
I'm a left-handed artist and I find that the cursor tends to favor a right-hander's tilt. The cursor goes to the left of my hand.
At number 1 we have the Huion 1060 Plus graphics tablet. Compared to the Wacom Intuos, the Huion 1060 Plus presents a lot of value in a small package. It has the same size working area as the Gaomon but costs less than half as much. It comes with a stylus and has 12 physical express keys that act as shortcuts to preset functions. In addition to the 12 physical express keys, it has 16 soft keys that you can access with the stylus. The standard Wacom pen is included, and it has a high-quality USB port as well. The build quality isn't as good as the Gaomon, but this is still a solid tablet at a reasonable price. While it can't match the Gaomon in terms of raw power, it definitely comes close enough for most users. Since it has 8GB of internal storage, you can use it as a USB flash drive as well. While it isn't the most powerful tablet out there, it is definitely a great budget graphics tablet option. In customer reviews, this is what they like about the 1060 Plus graphics tablet.
Side buttons are great and the pen pressure sensitivity seems consistent with my old Wacom tablets. I would definitely recommend it for anyone first starting in digital art or other designs.
And some customers had problems with.
One big downer is that there is no wireless capability. I tried to look for Bluetooth accessories but was not successful.
If you found any of the products in this video interesting, then you can find a link to more info and prices below the video. Thank you all for watching. If you found this video useful, please hit the like button to let us know. And also, hit the subscribe button now so you won't miss out on our new tips and review videos. And lastly, we also thought that you might like these other videos.